Hey guys, welcome to SFDCFacts. Starting today, we'll be starting a new series which we'll call Lightning Advanced Series. So we'll be looking at some of the advanced topics of Lightning. So let's say how you can create a custom cache mechanism, how you can improve your Lightning components performance, what are local services and what are the challenges comes with local services, what are the advantages that you will get with local services, what are the security mechanisms. So all these topics we'll be learning in this series. The first topic that I picked is like how you can improve your Lightning components performance using lazy instantiation. So we'll be seeing the live demo of how you can improve your components performance along with the time it takes with the improved code or the time it takes without lazy instantiation. So without any further ado, let's get started with the session. Let's have a look in general what actually the lazy instantiation is. So it simply means load your data when it is required. Don't load it in advance. So when your user is specifically is asking for a particular data, then only load it. Don't load it in advance, assuming that your user will request for it. So in Lightning experience, we already have few areas where if you host your component, that will automatically use the lazy instantiation. So some of those areas are like quick action, the utility bar and the app builder tabs. So let's say if you have a custom component and you are hosting a custom component within the within quick action or maybe the utility bar or maybe inside a Lightning app builder page. So that particular component will automatically use the lazy instantiation. What does it mean? So until unless your user click on that particular quick action or maybe click on that particular action on the utility bar, that particular component markup will never be loaded from the server, and so does it data. So that's how the lazy instantiation is automatically gets applied to the Lightning experience. Now there are few Lightning base components as well which allow us to use the lazy instantiation. Some of those are listed here, like the Lightning tab set, the Lightning tab, the Lightning tree and the accordion. So what does it mean? So let's say if you're putting your component within a Lightning tab or maybe within a Lightning tree, the markup of that particular component or the data from that particular component will never be loaded until unless your user is clicking on that particular tab or focusing on that particular component, maybe on Lightning tree. So this is the advantage you will get with these base Lightning component. There are many more. You can go through the component library to check all the list. Now, if you are talking about the lazy instantiation, we need to talk about the conditional rendering as well. So what does conditional rendering means? It means like showing or hiding your UI components based on some user actions. It can be done via CSS as well or using ORIF as well. So let's have a look at both of these and their advantage and disadvantages. So if you use CSS and you are hiding your component using CSS, it means your hidden component markup is still part of your DOM. So that means the complete markup, let's say if you have a markup of 100 lines of code, that is still part of your DOM. And if there are any listeners on any of those elements, they are still active in the backend. So do we need those listeners or do we need that markup as a part of our DOM even when they are not rendered? We don't need it, right? So that's when the ORIF is very useful. So if you use ORIF, the markup of a particular component will only be loaded from server when the condition inside is true attribute is true. And as soon as this condition becomes false, the complete markup will be destroyed along with those listeners which are related to that particular markup. So this will save you a lot of active listeners which are not needed, and this will give you a huge performance improvement on the browser side. So now let's see the demo of this. Okay guys, so this is the time for a quick demo. So to demonstrate lazy instantiation, I have an application with me called SFDCFacts News, which is designed with CSS as well. And there's one more application which is designed with the lazy instantiation as well. So if we talk about the CSS application, so this is how it looks. So there are five different type of news categories and there are about 200 records in each category. So if you scroll down, you will see like around 200 records on each particular category. The point number one, the performance. So if you see the CSS application, what it does, it loads all those records from all those categories in the first load itself. So if there are five different categories and each category has 200 records, that means on the first load itself, it is fetching 1000 records from the server.
And how much time it has taken to do that? Let's see. So if you see here, this has taken around 2900 milliseconds to fetch those records on the server. That means it is taking 3 seconds to load your page on the first go. But what happens if you see the same application using the lazy instantiation? So let's have a look at that as well. So if you click on the lazy instantiation app here, so that fetches the record within 900 milliseconds. So what's the secret here? The secret here is if you use the lazy instantiation, it's not loading those 1000 records from the server. It's only loading the 200 records which belongs to sports category. But if you want to load the other category as well, you can simply click on it and request for the data from the server. And that's when this will be loaded from the server. Now the point number two. So if you see here, there is a checkbox here which is called hide details. So if you click on this checkbox, it loads those complete articles from the backend along with the headlines. But let's see if you are checking it in the CSS application. Let's observe our DOM structure at that time. If I go inside my DOM, I see these articles there. They are the part of my DOM. But what happens if I unclick this checkbox? So if I unclick this checkbox, details is not showing up on the UI, but still part of your DOM. So in this case, if there is an event listener on this particular DOM, that is also active. If you go to our lazy instantiation app, which is designed using Aura If, we will observe the same behavior there as well. So let me just request for the complete data here, and then I'll simply see it in my DOM. So do you see here, I see this complete structure in my DOM here, and it's part of my DOM. But as soon as I unclick this checkbox, that particular DOM has been destroyed along with the listeners here. So using the lazy instantiation, you will get the better performance in terms of loading the records on the server, and better performance on the browser side as well by saving the listeners, by saving the listeners on the page which are active, and your DOM data. Now how I designed it, let me walk you through the code. So if you talk about the CSS application here, it's completely designed with the CSS classes here, where different categories are defined. And then I have the news component, which actually fetches the news from the server with the category. And I defined those here. So the news component remains same in both of these. But if you see here, I wrapped up this news component inside a div tag, and where I am changing the class to either show or hide based on the category, which is the current category got selected. So if the current category is sports tab, I'm showing it up and the hiding the remaining ones. But if we talk about the other application here, which is using the lazy instantiation, so instead of wrapping up my tabs inside a list element here, I'm wrapping those up inside a lightning tab here. So this will ensure that my component will always be initialized only when I am loading those data, only when the user is requesting for the data from the server, or only when the tab, that particular tab is being clicked. And if you see here, I am also wrapping this news component inside our Aura If here. And what this Aura If will ensure, that if that particular checkbox is checked or if it is true, then only it fetches those long description from the server, else it destroys those long description from the server. So this will ensure that you don't get a bigger DOM, and this will also limit the active listeners on the DOM element, so which will definitely give you a better browser performance. So this is how you can design your application. So whenever needed, use Aura If instead of the CSS conditional rendering, and whenever is needed, put your components within the lightning tab, or maybe the lightning tree or accordion, or wherever the lazy instantiation is supported. Don't load the data on the first go itself.